Hey, it's John from Enduring Charm. I got a quick little video today about how to cut extreme angles, especially on short pieces and pieces that might otherwise be dangerous to cut. And I'm gonna show you a little trick. So what you're looking at here is a whole pile of stakes that I'm rebuilding my truck body, and I need to make some cuts that are gonna just be, a very extreme angle here. I'm not even sure what the angle will be, probably 75 or 80 degrees or something right along here. I mean, one option is to use a table saw if you have one available. There are various sleds and jigs that you can use to keep, a piece like this upright. And then you could use the tilting action of the saw blade to cut your angle. You're going to be limited by the height of the saw blade, but that's one option. A band saw is another option. It's pretty safe. You can make cuts like this without too much of a problem at pretty much any angle you want. However, it's going to be freehand, and the accuracy may not be exactly what you're looking for. A radial arm saw is another option, but now you're starting getting into limitations about how far you can take that angle. Now, radial arm saw is capable of some pretty severe angles, but not the kind of angle that I'm talking about here. And then last, we get into the miter saws, right? So this is a sliding compound miter saw. There's just standard miter saws, whatever, but they're all same issue with this kind of cut, which is that it's limited. Now, this particular one, you can get up to 50 degrees, and a lot of them you're limited by 45 degrees. So again, this is not the kind of angle that I need. Now, you might be tempted, because it's not a big leap to realize, you could take this workpiece and put it at a different angle like this and make the cut, but it's not a safe cut. However, there is a way to make this pretty safe inexpensively, and I'm going to show you how to do that. All right, so here's the easy solution, and I've made this as simple as possible. There are definitely ways you could make this more sophisticated and maybe add some features to it, but this is just as simple as you could possibly get. So all I've done is created a 90 degree angle here using plywood, and I have a a cross piece here, triangulation to make it strong. So that's the jig, that's it. That's all you really need. Like I said, you could add things to it. You could add clamps, you could add various other devices to it, but I'm making this simple. So just a piece of scrap plywood. I got a clamp here that clamps it to the fence of the saw. That prevents it from going this way and that way. So that gives me a solid way to anchor the workpiece. And then I have a clamp here which stops the workpiece, well, it keeps it, flush here, but it also stops the workpiece from going back, because as I pull down on this miter saw here, the workpiece is gonna wanna shoot out the back, but this prevents it from happening. So this gives me a safe way to make a cut here. Now, I have the saw set at about 10 degrees, but this is at 90 degrees. So you can see how you can use these angles to get the angle that you actually need here. And if I make the cut, you can see I can make a very thin piece here, and I can do it safely, and now I'm able to do extreme angles that I wasn't able to do before. Now, one thing you need to think about is the height of this jig or fence that you're using here. If it's too high, then it could get in the way of the saw itself, so you have to think about that. And then the other issue to think about is, in this case, I'm doing a 2x basically on edge, so that's one thing, but what if I wanted to do a piece of 1x and cut it on the flat and have an extreme angle for that? Well, I'm just gonna use this piece of plywood here as a stand-in for 1x. So one option is you may, depending on your saw, be able to clamp the 1x on the flat to the saw surface itself. That's a possibility. Another thing to understand is that if the cut you're making does not go too far into the piece, so in this case, there's a lot of sawdust built up there, but back in here, there is actually a piece of fence, saw fence, that would prevent this board from shooting back. So depending on your cut, it may not be an issue. In other words, you can literally hold it by hand against this fence as long as you have that stop here, and that's okay. Right. right, so this is the last thing I'll mention here. Now, this, I will admit, is getting into more dangerous territory than I was just showing you before. So what we're doing here now is I want to cut this, this is actually a 2x, but it could be a 1x, either way. But I want to cut it right to the corner here, right? At an extreme angle. So because of that, there's not going to be anything holding this workpiece from shooting backwards. Now, possibly, again, depending on the saw, you can clamp it to the saw itself. And if you can, great, go ahead and do that. It's also possible, depending on the workpiece or what you're doing, you could even screw through this jig to hold it in place if you really had to. But let's just say you can't do any of that. A fallback would be a sacrificial fence in the back here. Now, the point of this is the fence is going to hold the workpiece until the end of the cut, in which case it stops giving support. So it's not as safe as what I was just showing you before, but it's fairly safe if you're comfortable with the saw. I do still have the fence, or this jig, I should say, clamped to the fence. So I still have support this way. I'm good there. It's just support going backwards. So I'm going to be careful, and if I can use my hands in the back here to help prevent it from slipping back, I'll do that too. All right, so you can see the line that I made here, and the fence is actually cut. But until that last moment, it's actually giving some support. So you can cut your angle at an extreme like this. Now, like I said, this isn't as safe as what I initially showed you, but I think it's doable for most people if you're careful and pay attention to what you're doing. Now, like I said, I just made this out of scraps here, and I'm just using clamps to hold it in place. If you wanted to make something more permanent, then you know, you could certainly make a piece that has clamps attached to it, permanently attached to this, that you could just clamp to the back of the fence. You might make it so it slips over the fence on both sides. You know, there's certainly other options you could have. There are certain types of commercial clamps you can buy that would be permanently affixed here and would apply pressure this way. So there's all sorts of things you could choose to do for the jig, but I wanted to demonstrate here, it really takes almost nothing, just scrap plywood to put something together quickly. So if you're out on a job site somewhere or you know, working outdoors with just a miter saw, throw this together and you have some means of making extreme angled cuts here with a miter saw.